The Nucleus LINK has some functions built in that will massively improve the quality of your roast, and I realize that a lot of users are not aware of these functions, but they are really simple to use, and this is why I'm going to show you the functions and I'm going to explain you step by step how you can activate them. To give you a little bit of context, the Nucleus team has actually rebuilt all the profiles in the Addis update, and they have defined so-called fan steps and zones in the development phase of your roast. If you have a look at the profiles right here, you can see these lines after the first crack on the fan curve, which are a bit like shark teeth, and these are the so-called fan steps. And then you see these colored fields here, which are the so-called zones. This is a function in the LINK software, which allows you to manage a curve at a particular point, for example, after first crack, where then the roast is getting exothermic, in order to get the profile a bit closer to the profile defined line. And this is something that the Nucleus team has done on all the roasting profiles, and you will then realize if you do a roast with these zones and fan steps activated and without, and taste them side by side, you will really realize a taste difference. And this is why it's important to use those steps. And what's also important to understand is, in order to use those steps, you need to mark the first crack. You have two possibilities to mark first crack. Either you do it manually, and this is the most precise way of defining the first crack. So you will listen to the roast, and when the first crack appears, so not the first pops of the first crack, but when it's getting regular, like da-da-duck, you either mark it manually on the machine or in the software, and then the development phase is beginning from that point. Or you have another option, and I'm going to show you also how you set it accordingly in the preferences. And in the other settings, you don't have to mark it manually, but the machine is then marking the first crack automatically at the point which is predefined in the profile. I'm going to show you now how this is being done, and in addition to that, some other functions that will help you to improve the quality of your roast. And now let's switch over to the menu. In order to do that, you press the menu button until you get to preferences. And in preferences, now you go to the point enable zones. And with the plus button, you can enable the zones. Then you go to enable fan steps, which you can enable also with the plus button. And now you have the functions activated that I just talked about. And as I also explained you before, you have the two possibilities to mark the first crack, and this is being set in this step here. So you see zones and fan steps are either relative to first crack with the plus button. In that case, you are going to mark first crack manually on the machine, either with the play button or in the software during the roast, or you can then also make it relative to time with the minus button. And in that case, it's taking the first crack that is predefined in the recipe, or let's say in the roasting profile. And now while we are here anyway, I'm going to show you the other settings that you can do in the preferences menu, because there are some interesting settings here as well. Let's start at the beginning. So we go into preferences. And then first of all, you see priority level or DTR. These are two versions to use the LINK. The level are so-called roast levels, which is something that is coming from the Cafe Logic system. I wouldn't recommend it to use it on the LINK. On the LINK, I always would recommend to use DTR, which is the development time ratio. That means the time in the roasting profile from first crack to the end of the roast divided by the whole time of the roast. So if you have, for example, a roast that is 10 minutes, you have first crack at 8 minutes, and then you have 2 minutes development time. In a 10-minute roast, that would be 20% development time ratio, just for you to understand it. And the LINK system is always working with this DTR in all the app, in the profile recommendations, and that's why you should have set it to DTR anyway. Now, this is a function that is related to what we have seen before. This means entered first crack or end. Should you keep it or should you reset it? This is then relevant when you have chosen to mark the first crack manually in the roasting profile. If you press on minus keep, then when you have done a roast and you do another roast with this exactly same profile, it will automatically mark the first crack at the point that you have defined in the roast before. So for example, if you do a lot of roasts with the same bean, with the same profile, and you don't want to always mark the first crack manually, you can just do all the roast, you mark it once, and then it keeps it in the next roast and sets it automatically at this point. If you then would set it to reset, then you always have to mark the first crack manually. If you don't do that, then the first crack will not be marked. In any case, also if you let it here on keep, you can still manually mark the first crack in a roast and then it will just override what is saved in the system. Then enable zones and enable fan steps, as well as this one here. This selection are the things we have just talked about. We go now to fan adjust, and this is a function which will allow you to adapt the fan during a roast. You will have seen in the roasting profile in your app that it recommends you sometimes to adjust the fan a little bit higher or a bit, little bit lower. In particular, if you have beans that are quite light or quite heavy, or beans that are quite small or quite large. And to use that function, you need to activate this fan adjust here. This is something that I would recommend you to do anyway. Put it on. And if you put it on, then before you start a roast, the machine will ask you for some fan adjustment steps, which are the steps that are predefined in your app. And another possibility that you have when you have fan adjusted on is that you can then adapt the fan during a roast. So if you're, for example, starting a roast and you realize that the roast is turning a bit too slow or a bit too fast, then you can just during the roast press on menu button, and then with plus and minus, you can increase the fan speed or decrease the fan speed just to correct a roast when you realize it's not properly as you have expected it to be. The next one here is always ask development time ratio. This is something that I always have set to yes. And the reason here is if you put it on yes, then the roaster will ask you before you start the roast about your development time ratio that you want to reach. And this is something that will help you to then predefine before you start the roast if you want to make it a bit lighter or a bit darker. You might have seen in the profile that it recommends you also a particular development time ratio, and therefore I would recommend you to set it on yes so that you have the possibility before you start the roast to define to make it a bit lighter or a bit darker as you prefer your coffee to be. And the last one is roast logging on or off. This is something that in most cases will always be set to on. Like that, the roast is being saved in the machine. The only scenario where it makes sense to put it on off is if you are, for example, using the machine always without the computer. For example, if you're somewhere in the field on a farm and don't have the possibility to connect it to your computer, then it might happen that at some time the memory will be overflowed for the machine, and then people are going to set it on roast log off. But in all the other cases, you just leave it on, and then when you connect the computer to your LINK roaster, it's going to synchronize the roast profile and the roast logs so that you have them saved on your computer. And the last thing here in the preferences is the possibility to choose if you want to work with Celsius or with Fahrenheit. If you have a machine that is being bought in Europe, then it's always preset on Celsius. And here you can then just choose it according to your preferences with what you want to work. This is all you are going to set in the preferences menu, but there is one more thing I want to show you while we are here at the menu of the machine, and this is the so-called fan preview, which you can access also with the menu button right here. If you go to fan preview, you can put 100 grams of a green coffee bean that you want to roast in your roaster, then start the fan preview, have a look at how the beans are turning, and then If you realize that the beans are turning too slowly or too fast, you can increase or decrease the fan adjustment with the plus and minus buttons. And if you then realize that for a particular bean, you need to increase it a little bit, for example, let's say by 1.5 steps, then you know it. And then when you start a roast, you have the possibility to set this fan adjustment before starting a roast. So you either take the fan adjustment that is being defined in your profile on the LINK app, or you can also then use here a value that you have discovered while you did a fan preview on your machine. I hope this video was helpful for you. If you want to know more about the Nucleus LINK, then have a look at our website where we have a lot of information about the machine, or you can always come back to me. You find my contact information as well as all the information on the LINK on our website, roasttravels.com.